Hello and welcome. In machine vision, image filters are everywhere. For example, they're used to reduce image noise, improve contrast, or detect edges. In this tutorial, I'll introduce you to some of the most commonly used filters in MVTec HALCON, how they work, and what they can be used for. First, we read an image of a plan with background texture. Our goal is to remove the background texture without changing the actual information too much. Let's start with an easy-to-understand common operator, mean image. In the resulting image, the background texture has been removed quite well, but a lot of relevant information has been lost. So, how does this filter work? To call mean image, we specify a mask size. For every pixel, a mask with the specified width and height is created. Then, we take the gray values inside this mask and compute the average. This new value is assigned to the center pixel. Thus, the image is smoothed very evenly. Another similar operator is median image. Again, this filter works with a mask. By default, a circular mask is used. The gray values are sorted, and the middle value is set as the new gray value. Thus, the median is a more robust average. Outliers don't influence it as much. Additionally, it is a lot better at preserving sharp edges. However, finer details like the number seen here are still quite blurred after applying the filter. For comparison, this is the result of the mean filter. There are many more operators that can be used to smooth the image. Have a look at the chapter reference of filters, smoothing, for a comprehensive overview. For removing the background noise in this image, using a rolling guided filter is an advanced choice. You can see the impressive results here in the documentation. The third image shows the extracted texture. To get this image, we use sub-image, an arithmetic filter. Here, we take the original image and subtract the image that was filtered by the median filter. The resulting image shows the extracted texture. Other frequently used filters in this category are invert image and scale image. Let's have a look at some common use cases of the basic filters we encountered in this video. Here, we read an image of a plant and add some salt and pepper noise. With median image, we can get rid of this noise very effectively. Additionally, white noise is a common problem introduced by hardware. Here, both the mean filter and the median filter produce okay results. With a rolling guided filter, the results look quite nice. Note, however, that the total runtime increases significantly. In this image of a solar cell, we want to get rid of the horizontal lines. Here, the median filter produces visually satisfying results. In the next image, our goal is to use a threshold to detect the defect. However, in the gray histogram, we don't easily see the defect. Hence, we apply a median filter. Now, this small hill becomes distinguishable and can be segmented easily. Similarly, filters can be applied before segmenting the image to create regions of interest. A good example would be a case where you want to read text in an image. This can improve runtime or increase robustness. Another common segmentation operator is DIN threshold, which uses a local threshold. Usually, the threshold image is a smoothed version of the original image. In this example, we roughly segment the braille with it. Another common use case for filters is the correction of the illumination. Here, we acquired an image with a backlit setup. Notice the illumination isn't completely uniform. To fix this, we acquire an image of the background and subtract this background image from the original image. The result is a much better illuminated image. In this image, we want to enhance the details. To do this, we first smooth the image. Then we subtract the smoothed image from the original, which gives us the details. Then we add those details to the original. Last, I would like to show you an effect that you have to look out for when working with filters. When working with reduced domains, most filters only return results for pixels that were contained in the input domain. Pixels outside this domain become undefined. This can lead to artifacts on the image borders when two or more filters are applied. In the chapter reference of filters, you can find some strategies how to solve this problem. As you can see here in the chapter reference, there are many more filter categories than we covered in this video. Have a look for yourself and get to know the endless possibilities of MVTec HALCON. Thank you for watching.